Yeah, can you just speak to what you thought of the, you know, the whole trilogy between Sam and Spencer?
Yeah, I loved it. You know, these guys both come in. It was exactly like the other fights. And it's funny because I was saying, Stout had said in his pre-fight interview that when he fought Stout the other two times, he was green and he felt like Fischer was in his prime then, and now he's in his prime and Fischer is, you know, shot. I thought Fischer looked better tonight than he has in a long time. I thought he fought a great fight. And, you know, they won fight of the night, so I think that says a lot.
And just to follow up, in the lead up, it seemed that that Spencer was kind of considering this to be his last fight. How do you want us to remember Spencer Fischer as a fighter?
Well, to be honest with you, if the fight went the way that he said in his pre-fight interview, I would agree with him. I thought Spencer Fischer looked as good as he's ever looked tonight. So maybe he'll rethink that.
Thank you. Question for Sam Stout. Sam, your wrestling looked like it was really a big factor in this fight. Just talk about that. I mean, landing those takedowns, and not only land them, but in key spots in the fight.
My wrestling game is something I've been working on for a long time and just kind of keeping, you know, on the low profile. And I grew up as a kickboxer that, you know, I was so conditioned to just defend takedowns and get back to my feet. But I felt this was the right time to, you know, showcase that I'm a mixed martial artist. I can do, you know, I can do it all. And I knew Spencer wouldn't be expecting it. And I knew it would give me the edge I needed to steal those rounds and get that win. Yeah. You know, we spent 45 minutes in that cage together. We, you know, that we got a bond together that, you know, is a pretty rare thing, that, you know, to go through a trilogy like that and have three wars with the same opponent. My hat's off to him. He's a class act. We spoke after the fight. You know, if I get out of this press conference before, while they're still selling drinks, I'm gonna go buy him a beer.
My question is also for Sam. Can you just talk a bit about having Mark Del Grande in your corner tonight, and also just how you felt mentally as compared to Tavares fight back in January?
You know, as most of you guys know, my coach and mentor and brother-in-law and one of my best friends, Sean Thompson, died last August. So, you know, he was in my corner for every single fight up until the Tavares fight. And I'm talking back to my amateur kickboxing days, every single fight I've ever had. He trained me from the ground up. So it's been very difficult for me to train or to fight without him. Fight with Tavares, I'm not making excuses as to, and saying that's why I lost. You know, he won that fight fair and square, but I needed to find somebody else who could, you know, I needed to start. I don't want to say fill his shoes because nobody could fill Sean Thompson's shoes to me, but, you know, I needed somebody who was putting a game plan together for me and, you know, reminding me and keeping me on track, somebody I could feel confident with in my corner, Mark Del Grande. I've always had a good relationship with him. We've always been friends, and him and Sean were very close, and I know that's somebody, that's who Sean would want in my corner. So I reached out to him, and, you know, I'm really glad our game plan worked out really well for us tonight.
Thanks.
Thank you.